Dear student, how are you? Everybody fine? Any problem? Yes, we are in our lecture number 4 for NEET and JEE, and our chapter is chemical bonding. Some concept discussed in our last lecture. Here we are going in one of the most important is a bond angle. And question asked many times in this point, bond angle. First of all, what is bond angle? Angle between two adjacent bond is called bond angle. Clear? And it is measured in degree, minute, or in second. Degree, minute, 109 degree and 28 minutes in second also. Some affecting factors to bond angle. Yes, one by one we will discuss. First of all, hybridization. Yes, sir. Hybridization affect bond angle or S character of hybrid orbitals. So bond angle is directly proportional with S character of hybrid orbitals. It means S character increases. Suppose I am giving you in sp3 hybridization, S character is only 25%. In case of sp2, which is 33.33%. In case of sp, which is 50%. So with increasing in S character in hybrid orbitals, bond angle increases. So first of all, BCl2, BCl3 and CCl4. Beryllium having 4 electrons in outermost orbit. So beryllium combines with 2 chlorine by sharing of 1-1 electron of each. So here no any lone pair, only bonding pair 2. So whenever bonding pair 2, so hybridization will be sp. You can see angle is 180. Now here S character is 50%. In BCl3, boron having 3 electrons in outermost orbit and all the 3 are bonded. So here bonding pairs are 3. So bonding pair 3 means sp2 hybridization, no any lone pair. We have to check here S character decreases, so bond angle decreases. You can see it is now 120. In the case of CCl4, carbon having 4 electrons in outermost orbit, all the 4 are bonded. Here bonding pair is 4. Hybridization will be sp3. So angle, now you can see once again S character decreased and bond angle also decreases. Now it is 109 degree and 28 minutes. Understood? With increasing, with changing in hybridization, otherwise S character decreases in hybrid orbitals, bond angle over decreases. Now second point, bond angle also depends upon lone pair, number of lone pairs, non-bonding electrons. Whenever hybridization same of the central atoms but lone pair are different, so bond angle is inversely proportional with number of lone pair electrons. I am giving you example for that, methane, ammonia and water. In methane, all the four electrons of carbon are bonded, so hybridization is sp3. In ammonia, central atom is nitrogen. It has 5 electron in outermost orbit. Out of 5, 3 is bonded, 2 are remaining, which is a lone pair. Here one lone pair. Here lone pair is 0. All the pair are bonding, 4. Here lone pair 1. Bonding pair 3. 1, 2 and 3. Hybridization sp3 same. 3 plus 1, 4. Here lone, one lone pair. Now in the case of water, oxygen has 6 electron in outermost orbit. Out of 6, 2 are bonded, so remaining are 4. So here lone pair is 2. Bonding pair is 2. Value of X is 4. So hybridization sp3. But you can see with increasing in the lone pair, bond angle decreases. In methane, bond angle is 109 degree, 28 minute. In case of ammonia, which is 107 degree. In the case of water, bond angle is 104.5 degree, near about 105 degree. Yes, hybridization is same. Number of lone pair increases due to VSEPR principle. Repulsion between lone pair is highest. Repulsion between lone pair bonding pair is less. And repulsion between two lone pair is very less. So bond angle is higher in case of lone pair 0. One lone pair repels 3 bonding pair. Here two lone pair repels 2 bonding pair. So repulsion is maximum between lone pair. So it repels to bonding pair and angle decreases. In different molecules, we are taking example, central atom are same and lone pair also same. So bond angle depends upon electronegativity of the atoms, in this case now in exam, so bond angle will be directly proportional with the electronegativity of the central atom. Yes, you can see which depends upon central atom's electronegativity. I am giving you example H2O and H2S. Here sulfur having also two lone pair, two bonding. Oxygen having two bonding, two lone pair. Hybridization in both same sp3 and atoms, connected atoms are same, central atom are different. So electronegativity is of oxygen is higher than sulfur. So in this case electron of bonding pair is attracted more toward oxygen than sulfur due to less electronegativity of sulfur. So here electrons are very close to the oxygen atom, so repulsion is more between them. So angle is 104.5 degree. Here electron is not moved like this, sulfur ni etla bada close nathi, so repulsion is less, so angle is 92. Understood? Reason for that electronegativity of oxygen is more than electronegativity of sulfur. Now another example we are going, ammonia, phosphine and arsenic hydride. You can see here hybridization is the same, lone pair is also same, one lone pair in each atom of the central, but electronegative of nitrogen is the highest, then phosphorus and arsenic. So electron is totally moved toward nitrogen, so electrons are very close to the nitrogen atom, so repulsion is more. So bond angle in ammonia is 107 degree. In phosphorus it is less toward phosphorus, now very less toward arsenic, so bond angle decreases. Here is 93, here is 91 decreases. So whenever hybridization same, adjacent atoms with central atom are same and lone pair same. So in this case with increasing in electronegativity of central atom, bond angle increases. Now next, central atom is same in the molecule, but side atoms, connected atoms are different. In this case bond angle is inversely proportional with electronegativity of side atoms, central atoms are a connected atom. Otherwise size of the side atoms which connected with central atom. Yes, I am giving you example OCl2 and OF2. Here lone pair same, hybridization same, central atom same, but electronegativity of side atom increases, then bond angle decreases. Why? Here electronegativity is more of fluorine than chlorine. So electron is moved toward completely fluorine atom. So the distance between electron already increased. So bond angle is 103. In the chlorine, electronegativity less than fluorine. So electron is totally not moved toward chlorine, but slightly toward oxygen. So repulsion is more. So bond angle should be more, 110. Understood? Otherwise, in case of size increases, central atom same, hybridization same, lone pair same, bonding pair same, but size of the side atom increases, bond angle increases. You can see fluorine karta chlorine is huge in size, so angle increases. You can see here angle is increased. Angle is increased. Understood? Now next, another example of it, PF3, PCl3, PBr3 and Pi3. Central atom same, hybridization same, all having sp3, 1-1 lone pair on each phosphorus atom, but side atoms are different. Side atom, size of side atom increases, so bond angle increases due to repulsion. In another word, we can say electronegativity decreases. Fluorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, bromine to iodine. So bond angle increases. Another OF2, then Cl2, then Br2. Here, fluorine having highest electronegativity, then oxygen. But oxygen having higher than chlorine, bromine and iodine. So whenever oxygen combines with fluorine, so fluorine became minus, oxygen plus. But whenever chlorine is combining with oxygen, so oxygen is minus, chlorine is plus. In the case of bromine same, oxygen minus 2, bromine plus 1. So positive radical comes first, so this represent like this. Here fluorine central atom same, all oxygen having 2 lone pairs, lone pair same, hybridization sp3 same, shape is bent, all of 3. Here size increases, fluorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, so bond angle increases due to repulsion between them. Size is more, electron is more. So repulsion between electron is more, size increases, same. SF2 to SCl2, SCl2 to SBr2, bond angle increases. Here two lone pair and two bonding pair, SF2, SCl2, SBr2, same. Hybridization is same in all of 3 sp3, two bonding pair, two lone pair. But central atom same, but adjacent atoms connected, bonded atom with central atom, size increases, so angle increases. Understood? Now what about now bond angle increases with increasing in side atoms. Bond angle increases with increasing in size of the side atoms. Once again, Cl2O having more bond angle than water. Here you can see two bonding pair, two lone pair. Here same, two bonding pair, two lone pairs. But hybridization also same. But hydrogen is small in size, chlorine is big in size. Central atom same, hybridization same, bonding pair same, lone pair same. But side atoms size increases, bond angle increases. Here is 10, 110. Here is 105. Now, example for it once again. OF2, once again OF2, Cl2O, NBr2. Actually, what happens there? In OF2, in OCl2, in OBr2, central atom is the same, bonding pair same, lone pair same. Hybridization in all of three is sp3. Here angle between 103 to 105. Here is in 109 to 111. Here is 116 to 118. Size of side atoms increases, so repulsion increases, bond angle also increases. Now point of the bond angle here over. Now another point is bond energy. Yes, actually bond energy are two types, bond formation energy and bond dissociation energy. First, bond formation energy. When bond forms between two atoms, released energy is called when bond forms between two atoms. Released energy is called bond formation energy. Suppose A and B, two atoms are combining, bond forms, so heat will be liberated, so that is called exothermic, and enthalpy change will be minus. Second one, bond dissociation energy. Needed energy to break bond between two atoms is called bond dissociation energy. Suppose bond is formed between A and B, we have to break, we have to separate two atoms. So heat we are applying, we are giving heat, so enthalpy change will be positive. So dissociation of bond always endothermic process. This one is exothermic. But in our chemistry, bond formation energy is too difficult to derive. So whenever fault comes a bond energy, so we have to take only bond dissociation energy. Bond energy means bond dissociation energy always take. If indication is given bond formation energy, then we have to take formation. Otherwise, when word comes bond energy means breaking of the bond dissociation energy. So now example, N2 having higher than O2, N2 having higher than FH2, H2 having higher than F2. Why? In the N2 there are triple bond between nitrogen. In case of oxygen there are double bond. In hydrogen there is single bond. Fluorine has also single bond, but why less than hydrogen? Reason for that, fluorine has 7 electron in outermost orbit. Out of 7, 1 is bonded. 6 are remaining as a lone pair. And another reason, fluorine is very small in size. So atoms are very close. So repulsion occurs maximum between lone pair electron. So bond dissociation energy less than hydrogen of the fluorine. In case of hydrogen, there is 1 electron. And one is bonded. No any lone electrons in hydrogen. So repulsion is less. So bond dissociation energy as hydrogen is higher than fluorine. Hereby more than hydrogen. Here double bond between them. Here higher. Highest in comparison of these three because of triple bond. Now some affecting factors to the bond energy. Some affecting factors to the bond energy. Yes, first of all is difference in electronegativity between two atoms. BE means bond energy is directly proportional with change in electronegativity, difference in electronegativity. A and B atoms say, then electronegativity difference jetlo high, bond energy high. Example, carbon having, sorry, first of all HF, HCl, HBr and HI. Here difference between hydrogen and fluorine, electronegativity is highest, then less in HCl, then less in HBr and in HI. So bond dissociation energy highest in HF. HF માં વધારે, નથી લેસ, કારણ કે આ બે વચ્ચે ઇલેક્ટ્રોનેગેટિવિટી નો ડિફરન્સ ઘટતો જાય છે. સો બોન્ડ એનર્જી ડિરેક્ટલી પ્રોપોર્શન વિથ ચેન્જ ઇન ડિફરન્સ ઇન ઇલેક્ટ્રોનેગેટિવિટી ઓફ બિટવીન ટુ એટમ્સ. નાવ સેકન્ડ અફેક્ટિંગ ફેક્ટર ઇઝ બોન્ડ ઓર્ડર. Bond energy is directly proportion with the bond orders. Bond orders means number of bonds between two atoms. Carbon having single bond, double bond and triple bond. With increasing in number of bonds between two atoms, bond energy increases. Here 79 kilocalorie per mole for breaking one mole bond. Here double bond, so 143.3 kilocalorie. Here is triple bond, so 199.0 kilocalorie is needed. So first of all affecting factor is change in difference in electronegativity between two atoms. Second affecting factor discussed, number of bond between two atoms. With increasing in number of bonds between two atoms, bond energy increases. Now, next affecting factor is the size of the atom. Bond energy is inversely proportional with the atomic size. Atomic size increases, then bond energy decreases. Atomic size decreases and bond energy increases, inversely proportional. Now, carbon-carbon having triple bond. Carbon-nitrogen having and nitrogen-nitrogen. Remember, number of bonds are same. So, we can compare. If number of bonds are different, so easily we can define, sir, which one stronger. Here, number of bonds are same between two atoms. From in any period, carbon to nitrogen, left to right, size always decreases. So carbon is big in size. Here both are big, one small. Both are small, so this one is more stronger. So bond dissociation energy high in the case of N triple bond. In some exceptions also, bond dissociation energy chlorine-chlorine is higher than bromine-bromine, but of the fluorine is less than both, and iodine is very less. Reason for that we discussed. Fluorine is very small in size. There are three lone pairs in outermost after formation of one bond. So this repels much more between them. Repulsion occurs more. So bond dissociation exceptionally less. It should be higher due to small size. But repulsion is maximum between electron-electron. So chlorine is higher. Chlorine karta big in size, bromine are exceptionally. And iodine is big in size. Bond dissociation energy decreases. Here, same. Sulfur-sulfur. Actually, oxygen karta sulfur is big in size. In group, top to bottom, size increases. So, oxygen having more, should be more than sulfur. But, sulfur, oxygen is very small in size. Very close, and there are lone pairs, two lone pairs over there. So repulsion is more. So exceptionally, bond dissociation energy higher of sulfur than oxygen. Now in group number 14, carbon, silicon, germanium. When we move top to bottom, regularly, carbon to silicon, silicon to germanium. Dissociation energy decreases. Why? Carbon karta silicon is big. Silicon karta germanium is big. So bond dissociation energy decreases. Now another affecting factor is bond energy directly proportion with the bond polarity. If bond is more polar, then dissociation energy is high. Bond is less polar, then bond dissociation energy is less. Example for that, HF, HCl, HBrn, Hi. Electronegativity we discussed of fluorine is high. So here polarity is maximum. Fluorine is more partially negative. Hydrogen is more partially. Bond is more polar than HCl. And HCl is more polar than HBr. HBr is more polar than Hi. So bond dissociation enthalpy energy both same. higher in case of HF. From HCl to HBr, HBr to Hi, it decreases. Yes, gradually decreases. Yes, bond energy also depends upon resonance. Bond energy of resonating structure should be high. In the benzene, there are three single bond and three double bond, but pi bond continuously moving its place. Due to resonance, we can't. Benzene is more stable. And dissociation due to carbon carbon 1 sigma and 1 pi, which is continuously delocalized. Place change karege continuously. So bond dissociation energy higher of the benzene. Now bond energy depends upon hybridization. With increasing in S character, bond energy should be high. Yes. When to in sp3, S character is 25%. In sp2, 33.33%. In sp3, 20. In sp 50%. S character increases, so bond should be stronger. So now whenever two sp hybrid orbital are combines and makes a sigma bond, so bond dissociation energy very high. If sp2 hybrid orbitals combining and makes bond, forms bond, so lower than sp and very lower than sp2 bond forms between sp3 hybridal orbital. Here reason is that sp3 is like this huge in size, sp2 is like this, and sp is very small. So due to smaller size, the bond should be stronger. Now bond energy inversely proportion with number of lone pair electron. Inversely, in between carbon carbon there is single bond, there is no any lone pair over there, but remember hybridization should be same. Yes, sp3. In nitrogen there is one single bond between NN, but there is one lone pair. Hybridization is sp3, but due to one lone pair bond energy decreases. Ahiya ek lone pair nahi, badi bonding pair chhe, ahiya one lone pair chhe. Lone pair increase thai, bond energy decrease thai. In oxygen, two lone pairs over oxygen. Here also sp3 addition, but lone pair is two, so repulsion is more, so bond energy decreases. In fluorine it is very less. Why? Here hybridization is also sp3, but why decreases? Whenever hybridization same, but lone pair increase time. Here is one, here is two, here is three. So repulsion became more and bond dissociation energy decreases due to that. Now some important points we are going to discuss for your exam. Important points you have to store in your mind. Bond strength, कंपाउंडली मजबूत है, डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शन टू ओवरलैपिंग ऑफ ऑर्बिटल्स. इफ हाइब्रिड में ओनली ऑर्बिटल्स आर गिवन, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स, मैक्सिमम ओवरलैपिंग शुड बी मोर स्ट्रॉन्गर दी बॉन्ड. बॉन्ड स्ट्रेंथ इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शन विथ साइज ऑफ ऑर्बिटल. साइज इंक्रीज थाय बॉन्ड स्ट्रेंथ डिक्रीज थाय, साइज डिक्रीज थाय बॉन्ड स्ट्रेंथ इंक्रीज थाय. एक्साम्पल फॉर देट 1s and 2p combines, 1s and 3p combines and 1s and 4p. Here 1s overlaps with 2p, 1s with 3p, 1s with 4p, which is using size 3p and 4p. Size of orbital increases, bond strength decreases. If orbitals are of same orbit, so bond strength is directly proportional with overlapping of orbitals and directional properties. S is non-vector, non-directional. P is directional, px, py, pz. D is more directional, which lying in five direction. F are more directional, like this. Directional orbitals having bond should be stronger. 2p, 2p on axis should be stronger. Then 2s and 2p axis upar, axial. 2s, 2s, then axial. And collateral, 2p, 2p. Collateral means perpendicular. 2px, 2px combining. So pi bond forms, which should be less. Here is 1, 2s and both 2s. 2s is not directional. Both are two directional. I believe directional che, but axial nothing, but collateral che, matlab vertical che, horizontal nothing, overlapping, vertical che. Ela v koi pi ho. A 2s, 2s sigma ho, axial che, pana bhai non-vector che. One is non-vector, but one is vector. One directional, here both non-directional. One directional and one non-directional. Here both are directional and on axis. So this one should be more stronger. Strength of the pi bonds. 2p pi. 2p pi is more stronger. 2p pi, 3d pi. Then this one more stronger than 2p pi, 3p pi. And then 3p pi, 3p pi. Why? Here both are of third orbit. So bond should be weak. Here one of 2p and one of 3p. Here size is smaller, so more strong. But here 2p, 2p common. But here is 3d and 3p. Out of 3p and 3d, more directional. This lying down in 5 direction. This one in 3. More directional. Of the same orbit. I thought orbit, third orbit. So p karta d more directional ke bhai. So overlapping more. Here both are of second. So very close. So pi bond is more stronger. At room temperature, O double bond O is possible, where S double bond S is not possible. Why? One of sigma, one of pi. Oxygen is small in size. So here 2p, 2p forms a pi bond. So it should be strong. In sulfur, here 3p, 3p overlaps. So pi bond is a weak. 3p, 3p. Very weak. So S double bond is not possible in a room temperature. Same. At room temperature, N triple bond N is possible, but P triple bond P is not possible. Same reason. Here 2P, 2P forms pi bond. Nitrogen, nitrogen 1 sigma and 2 pi. 2PX, 2PX makes pi bond. 2PY, 2PY forms pi bond. So P pi, P pi, but 2P, 2P bond. In phosphorus, there should be 3P. So overlapping due to size is not possible. So pi bond never forms between PP triple bond. So N2 is possible, small size, 2P, 2P overlaps. Same. Now, CO2 is possible where SiO2 is not possible. Same reason. Here 2P, 2P overlaps due to small size. Here 3P with 2P, big size. So pi bond never forms. In SiO2, one silicon combines with four oxygen, single bonded. And one silicon with four oxygen, one oxygen with two silicon. So CO2 at room temperature forms a pi bond. So individual molecule possible. So CO2 is gas, where SiO2 is a solid at room temperature. Three dimension network. Now bye. We will meet in our next lecture.